Good evening. We have two dances we would like to minister to you this evening. The first dance is called Perfect Peace. I don't know what you've been through this week. But God can give you perfect peace. His mind is stayed on Him. Not on what's going on, but on what's on Him. And then our second dance we will minister to you this evening is called Stand Up for Love. And we've been studying about love week after week. God is love. There is power in love. Stand up for love.
Amen.
Just to be belongs to you.
Lisa. to say a prayer.
Hallelujah.
There's more than one way to show forth the glory of God.
Amen.
There's more than one way. There's more than one way. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. This is the opening night of the 12th Women's Retreat from Metropolitan A.M.E. Zion Church. And we are happy to have you. Scripture will be read today. The Old Testament, Sister Sharon Cage. New Testament, Sister Flaxine Smith. Prayer followed by prayer by Reverend Ruby Watson. And our opening statement by Reverend Michael Elmer.
Amen.
Amen.
Our Old Testament scripture will be coming from the book of Psalm, number 5. Verses 1 through 8. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Give heed to the voice of my cry, my King and my God. For to you I will pray. My voice you shall hear in the morning, O Lord. In the morning I will direct it to you, and I will look up. For you are not a God who takes pleasure in wickedness, nor shall evil dwell with you. The boastful shall not stand in your sight. You hate all workers of iniquity. You shall destroy those who speak falsehood. The Lord abhors the bloodthirsty and deceitful man. But as for me, I will come into your house in the multitude of your mercy. In fear of you, I will worship toward your holy temple. Lead me, O Lord, in your righteousness because of my enemies. Make your way straight before my face, the word of God for the people.
Amen.
The New Testament reading will come from Matthew 6, verses 5 through 14, through 15. That's Matthew 6, verses 5 through 15. Therefore, do not be like them. I'm reading from the New King James Version, and verse 5 says, and when you pray, you shall not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and on the corners of the streets, that they may be seen by men. Assuredly, I say to you, they have their reward, but you, when you pray, go into your room, and when you have shut your door, pray to your Father who is in the secret place, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you openly. And when you pray, do not use vain repetitions as the heathens do, for they think that they will be heard for their many words. Therefore, do not be like them, for your Father knows the things that you
have need of before you asked him. In this manner, therefore, pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from evil, from the evil one. For if you forgive, and for yours in heaven and the power and the glory forever. For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. May the Lord have a blessing on the reading of his holy word for his people. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Woo!
Of Metropolitan A.M.E. Zion Church, the guest speakers and members of Metropolitan A.M.E. Zion Church, we welcome you to the opening night of the 12th Annual Women's Retreat of Metropolitan A.M.E. Zion Church. How can we say welcome to such an awesome event? I'm going to attempt to welcome you with these few words that make up the word welcome. Let us worship the Lord with all our hearts. Embrace the moments we will be spending together with each other for the next 42 hours or so. Lift our hearts and voices to the Lord and sing that wonderful song, Kumbaya, my Lord. Kumbaya, my Lord. With the wonderful presence of the Spirit, with the praise and dance.
Amen.
Open our minds and soul to the marvelous indwelling of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Magnify the matchless
Hallelujah.
Name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, with our mouths. Experience the power and the inner spirit while praying and giving thanks to the one who has kept us safe thus far.
Amen.
Welcome one, welcome two, welcome all. God bless you.
Amen.
Thank you, Sister Murray. Surprise, surprise, surprise. And ladies, wasn't that quite awesome? Hey, they're big in the house. Thank you.
for your offering. And we want to thank the wonderful dancers that ushered in the Holy Spirit. You know, I have seen dancers and dancers, but totally surrendered. They never cease to move me because they are so spirit-filled. And no matter what is going on, they do what they're supposed to. So I just want to thank totally surrendered for ushering in the Holy Spirit. And now comes the big part. I get to introduce the speaker of the hour, Dr. Reverend Evangelist Evelyn Hudson.
My.
This is a wonderful woman of God. And I have been in her presence. I have talked to her on the phone. And there is not any hint of fakeness in her at all. I just want to tell you what I think. She invests every time that we have a retreat. And she comes, she invests in our retreat. She invests by paying someone's way to the retreat. She's done this even at times she wasn't able to come. She invested in our retreat. And also, as most of you know, she is a product of Metropolitan. We always claim you. We always claim you, but I want to give you a few statistics about her that you might not know. Dr. Hudson has been employed at City Vision Ministries for 4 years. She is the Vice President of Operations, formerly worked at the Salvation Army and Douglas National Bank in Kansas City, Kansas. Prior to those employees, she was at Hallmark for 18 years. She is active in her community. She has received the 2001 Distinguished Leadership Award and the 2002 Black Distinguished Women Award in Kansas City, Kansas.
My.
And she has a long list of degrees. Bachelor of Arts, Master Degree of Theology, Faith Bible College, Master's Degree of Scriptural Psychology, Faith Bible College, Doctorate Degree, Scriptural Psychology, Faith Bible College, Certified Christian Counselor. That's for all of you guys who needed to hear that. I just know this woman can preach your socks off. And somebody said that Bishop Leek said he used to say preachers could preach your socks off and your shoes still on. And your shoes would still be on. I believe she can do that too. So after this great choir, chorus, men's chorus, after you hear them, the next voice you will hear will be Dr. Evelyn Hudson.
My. Thank you. Don't wait till the fire comes. Go ahead and praise him right now. Thank you, God. together. You know, it's all about teamwork and worshiping God together. We're excited to be here on this evening, and I bring you greetings from Memorial Missionary Baptist Church. I'm under the leadership of Bishop Larry and Pastor Olivia Aiken, and they love you all and know that I come here on a regular basis and they don't have no problem with it. Amen. I just thank the Lord for that. Let's just quickly go to the throne of grace. Father, we just thank you. Thank you for that name. Thank you for the people that have already been praying. We feel a stirring in our spirits already, God, from the very onset with the dancers, oh God. The Holy Spirit has arrested us and got our attention. And Father, while we're here in your presence, speak to us. Silence Evelyn. Let your voice be the voice that says, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. We need a word from you, God. Stuff is happening all around us. We know that, God, there is a mission of prayer. And Father, we just need to hear from you. I pray that we leave this place changed, altered, that we become closer to you, that we yearn more of you, that we seek you more, that we even pray more, that we love each other more. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord. Amen. And amen. Would you go with me quickly to Matthew chapter 21? And we're going to use one of the theme verses for this weekend. Amen. And if you say amen with me, amen. It helps me move a little quicker. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Oh, now you're coming through strong. Amen. Matthew chapter 21, I'm going to read at least 3, maybe 4 verses so you can kind of get a feel of what's going on. And then we'll come back to the scripture text after we talk a little bit about the purpose and rewards of prayer. So Matthew chapter 21, and I'm going to start at verse 12 and read down at least through 15. I'm going to ask you to stand with me. Amen. Matthew chapter 21, verses 12 through 15. And Jesus went into the temple of God and cast out all them that sold and bought in the temple, and overthrew the tables of the money changers and the seats of them that sold doves, and said unto them, it is written, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but ye have made it a den of thieves. And the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. And when the chief priests and the scribes saw the wonderful things that he did, and the children crying in the temple and saying, Hosanna to the Son of David, they were sore displeased. I'm going to read one or two more verses. And he said unto them, hearest thou what these say? And Jesus saith unto them, yea, have ye never heard out of the mouth of babes and sucklings thou hast perfected praise? And he left them and went out of the city into Bethany, and he lodged there. And I just want to read the core scripture for this evening. And he said unto them, it is written, my house shall be called the house of prayer, but ye have made it a den of thieves. Amen. You may take your seats. The purpose and rewards of prayer. And, you know, down through the years, we've heard of prayer and known of prayer, and we're excited about prayer. And then after so long, you talk about prayer so long, and people, it's like it's boring or something. But it's gotten kind of interesting to me because I realize it's going to take somebody praying to get some stuff done. Come on here, somebody. I just realize it's more than a shake and a bake. It's going to take place of prayer. Amen. So, in looking at the word prayer, this particular text, the original text, the word prayer actually meant to worship God. And in many cases, we hear a prayer, we consider prayer as a tool to communicate to God, just talking to God, just having a conversation with God. I'm so thankful we can do that. We don't have to get the priest's permission or the pastor's permission. We can go straight to God for ourselves and communicate to God for ourselves. For the priest don't know what's down on the inside of our heart, but God does, and I can go straight to his throne. And all of this is confirmed. I heard one of the ladies read earlier, the Lord's Prayer. I'm just going to take a little bit of time to talk about the purpose of prayer, even in the Lord's Prayer. And I won't be before you long if you keep on saying amen. I always like to use the words, the acronym ACTS, A-C-T-S. To describe the purpose of prayer. A-C-T-S. Acts. A-C-T-S. So A would be to acknowledge God. C would be to confess our sins. T would be thanksgiving. And I put a slash mark by that because we're going to deal with the temptation factor. And then the last one, S, is for supplications. Now, let's go quickly through these and we're going to move on. First of all, in our prayer, in our communication with God, one of the first things we have to do is acknowledge that there is a God. And you may say, well, that's crazy. Everybody know that. No, everybody don't know that. And the more I read on different stuff on the internet, the more I realize folks really don't get it. Amen. There is only one true and living God. Amen. And it's
to temptation. And I'm so thankful that as we pray that prayer, I believe God is not leading us into temptation. Sometimes we take ourselves there, and sometimes temptation just finds us. Come on here, somebody. You be minding your own business. Come on here, somebody. And then here comes temptation. She said, and he was fine, too. Okay, all right. Lead us not into temptation. There's no need of playing with this thing.
Reports around our city, and I listen to the news, and my heart is devastated.
Georgia. And I called and I asked them, have y'all seen my son? I've been trying to contact him. And the commander said, ma'am, he said, we haven't seen your son, but quite frankly, the army is better without him. So as a mom, I know he was probably telling the truth. But that's still my baby. In the first part of chapter 21, Jesus is real close to Jerusalem. In fact, he's in the Mount of Olives with his disciples, and he tells them, I want you to go and get me a donkey. And so the disciples go and tune up just like Jesus said. They got the donkey and everything, and Jesus gets on the donkey, and he starts this parade. And it was a parade of awesomeness, of display. It was like he was a celebrity, if you will. But he came in different from most celebrity people. Most celebrities would have rode in on a big gold chariot.
You know it.
With beautiful white horses. They would have had shields of gold and a headrest and fine robes and linens and fancy boots. Come on here, somebody. But Jesus came in on a little lonely donkey.
Mercy.
But yet the people began to praise because they saw the miracles that he had done. And so they're grabbing branches off the trees and they're laying them down. And different ones are taking off some of their robes and laying them down for him to walk as he does this parade down to Jerusalem. And so finally he reaches Jerusalem and the people are so excited and they're saying, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King of Kings. This is our King, the King of Jerusalem, the King of the Israelites, our King. And then Jesus rolls up to the temple. Now let me give you an example of what the temple, there's an outer court of the temple and an inner court. Well, one of the things that happens when they would go to the temple is they would take a sacrifice. See, y'all thought the church is trying to take all your money. No, this is down through ages. You always bring an offering. Come on here. Always bring an offering. So they would bring their offerings. Well, many times the offerings would die along the way because their offering might be an oxen, it might be sheep, it might be goats, just variety turtle doves. It could be a variety of different things according to the old covenant in the Old Testament. So they brought up their offerings. Well, in the event they didn't have the offering with them, they could buy it in the outer court. So in other words, there's a whole lot of selling going on. Step up, step up. Get your sheep over here, 2 for $20. Come on here, somebody. Get your turtle doves over here. Get your turtle doves for your peace offerings right over here. Come on, come on, come on, ladies and gentlemen. How about a goat? Here's a he goat, here's a she goat. What would you like today? Ma'am, you can have 2 for the price of 1. Today we got a special going on. All of this, what's going on in the outer court. Before they got to the inner court at the temple. So Jesus is watching all of this stuff going on. And he is angry. He is ticked off. So he goes in, he throws down the tables and destroys all the booths. Come on here, somebody. And pushes people out the way and might have hit somebody. You know, you never know. Just moving stuff out the way. Because he is mad. And then he says, it is written, my house shall be called the house of prayer. In other words, you got it all messed up. I don't want you coming to church to sell stuff. Come on here, somebody. Don't come to the temple to get your business on. Come on here, somebody. He said, it shall be called the house of prayer. But you made it a den of thieves. So the Lord began to drop this in my spirit. I said, well, Jesus, this is the 21st century and we don't do the goats and the sheep and all that anymore. So what are you trying to say? He said, 3 words. I said, Lord, what are those words? Distraction, hindrance, and interference.
Yes.
Distraction, hindrance, and interference. Jesus is saying, I'm trying to get to church. The people in the car, they done flipped me. Come on. Amen. Come on in, because I done cut them off, you know. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
I get to the church. Come on.
Tell the truth.
And I'm hindered. Come on, come on. Can I get a couple volunteers? Yeah, I'm trying to get to church. Church is this way. Don't let me get through there. See, I'm just trying, that's all I'm trying to do. Y'all see what I'm saying? I'm hindered.
That's right.
I'm hindered.
That's right.
But something about prayer, it makes you, it helps you not be a hindrance. Come on here, somebody. It's something about prayer that breaks down all that junk and just say, well, pray for me. Pray for me. And keep right on stepping. Come on here.
Yeah.
You go, yeah, man, you haven't heard. It's real. need prayer. Jesus in your heart.
Yes.
If you have not, would you raise your hand?
Yes.
If you have not asked Jesus to come into your heart.
All right.
Amen.
Glory.
Remember I told you he's a soul man.
Yes.
He wants your soul.
Yes.
Amen. Everybody is accounted for. And now we just want to pray.
Yes.
Is that all right with you?
Yes.
I promise I won't be long. Grab somebody by the hand.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
I need prayer too. Let me grab my
hand.
Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we thank you on tonight.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
Woo! Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Thank you, your heart, I pray.
Yes.
Many times we pray to miss.
Yes.
Many times we miss the mark.
Yes.
Many times we did not pray your word.
Introduce the ladies on the pulpit.
we have Reverend Lula Williams here with us from Bowie, Maryland. She is she will be our speaker Sunday morning. She was the wife of Bishop Williams.
Amen.
And she's here to bless our hearts.
Amen. Yes, Lord. Amen.
We're just really glad to have her.
Amen.
Reverend Barbara White.
Amen.
Bless us Saturday night.
Amen.
Reverend Janet Johnson.
Amen.
She's here from Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Amen.
Sister Reverend Evangelist Arlita. No. nothing and did I forget something? I would like our pastor, Reverend Michael Elmer, to come and introduce us and give us remarks.
This morning. We want to thank you for being here. And I'm going to go ahead and talk a little bit about Jacqueline. Y'all, you know, y'all was eating and sleeping and stuff at 7:30 this morning, but Jacqueline was here ready. And she like, what y'all dressed up for? I was like, well, we ain't going to have time to go back and change, so we had to come ready because we got to eat too. But she had a little exercise equipment, all her little information in her seats and passing out all kinds of little pamphlets to help us to learn how to take better care of ourselves. And African-American women, we have some issues, some health issues that we need to address. You know, and she's not like a health professional, but she has so many passions, and that is one of her passions, is that women's health, and she wants to talk to us about our health. You know, she said, we have the highest risk of heart attack. Can you believe that? And breast cancer, we're most likely to die than anybody else, you know, of other persuasions of breast cancer. You know, so she was here to help us to learn how to take care of our bodies. And a bit of information she gave, this may not work for you, but you might think about it. Like from 7 a.m. In the morning to 7 p.m., you can eat pretty much whatever you want. But after that, no solid foods. And she said she did that and then she lost 8 pounds just doing that. Amen. You know, just eating. Don't eat after 7. That's basically, just eat liquids. And one thing that she said this morning too was that, that I didn't know, but she asked how many people drink soda? Raise your hands if you drink soda pop. What does it destroy in your body? Our bones. That's what soda destroys in our body is your bones. It affects your bones. And if you want to know what KGTSIR means, you should have been here this morning because I'm not going to tell you. But if you got your little pamphlet, you pass out a little book. So you can, if you got this, each one of you, if you don't have one, they were back on the table, it is in there. So you can read that. It's one in your bags. I understand it's one in your bags. So if you don't have one, you can look in there and find out what that's all about. And Jacqueline has been a blessing to our retreat. She even supports it financially. This year, she brought 5 people with her. I think last year was her first time, or second time. But she always comes. She always supports. With her presence and with people, and then she just like, can I just present something on health? And we're like, oh, sure. And a very intelligent woman, beautiful woman. Don't let her fool you. She's smart, smart, smart. She got a degree. She's a scientist. So, very intelligent. And at Metropolitan, she was the one that they founded an aviation academy. And she was the one soliciting through our church and others to get children to come to aviation camp for free. And can you imagine, it was hard to fill up those seats? And it was really hard to fill up the, I mean, they were flying planes, y'all. And it cost thousands of dollars for one child to go. And we were like begging people to go. And so, but she was the one that helped found that program. So I just wanted, she's not here, but I just wanted to give her props for what she did this morning and for the support she's provided, not only to the retreat, but also to our children. She has a passion for children.
Amen.
So God bless each and every one of you this morning. You're in for a blessing. God is here. He's in this place. He got you here for a reason. You're not here by chance. So don't think that you're here by chance. We're going to start this morning with our scripture. Is Miss Ruther White here? She's not here. Okay, we'll start our scripture. We'll start this morning with a scripture by sister, and she is my sister, Marianne Harsby. And then we'll have prayer by Reverend Janet Johnson in place of Sister Ruther White.
Good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
I'm reading out of the Life Application Bible, so I'm going to read the breakdown of the scripture first. And it says, the emphasis here is on God's will, not our will. When we communicate with God, we don't demand what we want. Rather, we discuss with Him what He wants for us. If we align our prayers to His will, He will listen, and we can be certain that when He listens, He will give us a definite answer. Start praying with confidence. And the scripture is 1 John 5th chapter, 14th and 15th verse. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. And if we know that He hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have what we ask of Him. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of His word.
Amen. Let's bow our heads. In honor of my sister Jean, this is how she likes to start her prayers. What a friend we have in Jesus.
Yes.
All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Good morning, Father. Good morning, Son. Good morning, Holy Spirit. We come boldly before your throne of grace this morning to seek grace and mercy to help in our time of need. We don't always know what to do, but we know the one who knows what to do. So we come seeking your divine guidance, Lord. We come asking for your direction as you plant into each one of us over this weekend, that it would fall on good ground, that the seeds planted would fall on good ground and would multiply 100-fold in the lives of your daughters. We're so grateful for this opportunity, Lord. So we invite your Holy Spirit to come in. We know your word says you would never leave us or forsake us, but we want you to know you are welcome in this place. We need you in this place. Our desire is for your presence. So permeate this place with your presence from floor to ceiling and from wall to wall. Leave not one of us untouched by your power today. Prune us, purge us, cleanse us of all the things in our lives that are not like you, O God. Wash us with the water of the word, O God. And bring to the forefront of our minds any sins that we push to the back, Lord. Bring it to the forefront of our minds. Let us confess it, repent of it, turn our backs on it, O God, so that it would not hinder our intimacy with you, our relationship with you. We love you, God, and we need you. So come, Holy Spirit, with all of your quickening power, and do a work in us and through us as we come yielded vessels, surrendered vessels, completely and totally to your good and perfect will. We don't want your permissive will. We want your good and perfect will for each one of us as we desire to grow and mature in the things of God. Catapult us, oh God, to this next level, Father. You know what we need. And so we come, empty vessels. Fill us, saturate us with your Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we pray and do give thanks. Hallelujah, praise God, and amen.
Amen.
So be it.
How many were with us on last evening? Raise your hand. Okay, very good. I want to know, what did you learn? What did you get out of the message last night? Anybody want to testify? Ask. What does that mean? Acknowledge. Confess. Thanksgiving. Okay, temptation. Supplication, which means to be. Hey, it's all right. He's our daddy. How many of you got one? I know you're begging me now, man. You got one in the natural, so it's all right to beg in the spiritual, too. So you got, okay, now, what else did y'all learn last night? I heard somebody start with distraction. So, okay, we're not going to have anybody distracting folks today, right? You're not going to be a hindrance to anybody seeing the Lord, or being saved, or going to that next level. Okay, not a distraction. You're not going to be talking about folks and stuff like that while the service is going on. All right? Okay. That could be a distraction. I'm just saying that could be you might have your own distraction. I said, you know, I'm usually passing out candy and chocolate and all kinds of stuff during church. I said, oh, I guess that's a distraction. And so Alice said, no, go ahead and pass out the chocolate. He said, no, go ahead and pass the chocolate. And then we don't want to be a hindrance, and we don't want to be an interference. And you can be it and not even know it. So you just need to kind of evaluate yourself. Don't say, yeah, so-and-so talked to me through the whole service. But you there listening. You ain't got to move to nothing. You just like, yeah. So don't be a distraction or hindrance or be an interference. At any time, not just today, but just at any time. Okay, anybody else learn anything? He's a soul man, and he's what? Faster than the speed of light. I said, whoa, never thought about it like that, but I guess so. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Mm-hmm. And he can do it like what? Boom, like that. Hey, in the midst of turning over tables and whipping people out the temple, he's gonna say, be healed, boom. So we like, my soul was blessed. I was like, oh, just hit me some more. So my soul, I love hearing the word. It does so much to me. It does so much to me. When my heart is sad, read me some scripture, send me a scripture, it just make me, I'll be crying at work. You know, just because that word just means so much to me. It is just, it's powerful. It's right. That's, he is the word. He is the word. He is love. He is the resurrection. He is the life. He's everything. He is the way. He is the truth. So God is everything. He is your peace. He is your joy. You can't have any of that stuff without Christ. You can't have any of it. Might have it for a little while, but it ain't gonna last because it's superficial. You can't have it without the Lord in your life. So God is truly being blessed. You all look blessed, and we're blessed to be here. We're blessed to be in this nice hotel, in nice rooms, eating that good food. I thought I was gonna get my omelet this morning, but the brother hooked me up. Okay? He hooked me up. I said, now this line is long. Mary said, let's just wait 5 minutes and see how it goes. He took them eggs and slapped them across the grill. What do you want? Bam, 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 flop, flop, flop. I had my omelet, plenty of time to eat. So I tell you, he hooked us up, got his energy. God is God. I ate my fruit, drank my juice. So God is truly good. And we are just blessed to be in such a wonderful facility, such good food, among such beautiful women, powerhouse women, anointed women, full of the Holy Ghost. They have to preach to us what thus says the Lord. Through them, not from them. So God is truly good. And I'm here right now to introduce our speaker. Most of you probably know her. If you were here last night, you know who she is. Miss Dr. Reverend Evelyn Hudson. What was her sermon last year? Y'all remember her sermon last year? At the Sunday morning service? Pull that, is it pull that?
Pull that sucker.
I know it had sucker in it, but I just couldn't. I know it had sucker in there somewhere, but I just couldn't remember the rest of it. You know, so, you know, she's not new to us, and we know that God is using her mightily, not only here in the church, but also in the what's going on in the community. She's very active in the community. She currently is the Vice President of Operations for City Vision, and you can read in our program the great things that they're doing in that ministry. She has also held several major roles in our community. She worked for the Salvation Army, and she also was employed by Hallmark Cards. She only looked that old to me to be somewhere for 20 years, 18 years at Hallmark Cards, so that's a it's a blessing to be anywhere for 2 years right now. So it's a blessing. She worked for Hallmark Cards for like 18 years, and you can see she's very active in the community. She is a chair of the board of directors for leadership in 2000, a member of the Kansas City, Kansas Chamber of Commerce, president of the downtown Kansas City. So she's a leader. President of the Turtle Hill Neighborhood Association, member of the Women's Chamber of Commerce, and a member of the Central Exchange. She's won a Distinguished Award of Leadership in 2001 and in 2002, the Black Distinguished Women Award in Kansas City, Kansas. She's well educated, but very down to earth. She just puts it right where it needs to be, right on the level that everybody can understand it. You ain't got to go home and look it up in the dictionary and try to figure it out. But she lays it right out, right where we are, and right where you can understand it. But she has a bachelor's of arts degree. There's nothing wrong with education. Some people think it is, but you know, it's nothing wrong with getting education. Bachelor of Arts in Human Resource Management, Master's in Theology, Master's in Scripture Psychology, Doctorate in Scripture Psychology, and also a certified Christian counselor. I need a session. But that just lets you know where she is. And sometimes you need somebody, you need a professional at times. You know, sometimes your friends can't do the job. You know, so it's no harm to seek it out, professional help and advice. And if they're a Christian, that just makes it all much the better. So we thank God for what God has done in her life and what God has done with her, in her, and through her. We thank God for the anointing that he has poured out in her and the way she's able to translate it to the body of Christ. We just thank God that she takes time out of her schedule and is committed to being a part of this women's retreat. She's not only, like I said, she's not only invested in the retreat, but we invite her to meetings. She helped give us some advice, get a different point of view on how we can make this retreat better. And we just thank her for everything that she's done. She is a product of our church. Her sister and I were in the same class together at Metropolitan Catechism class. So I know her sister. I didn't know her as well as I knew her sister. But I just thank God that she is here with us today and that God is using her. And y'all need to pray with her and for her as she comes before us to preach the gospel without any hindrances, without any distractions, without any interference. And we just ask God to say, just be with her And I just want all of us to say together, preach the word.
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 Amen. We got Kim's going to come back with another selection, and then after that, you will hear from Dr. Hudson.
The mission of prayer, the prayer mission. I've been on a personal